tubes of these cells are interconnected. A network emerges that can process vast amounts of information. Really obvious question. And those who can. You have to expand the mind. During the release, it's possible to test whether or not these electrical networks are thinking.
We have the opportunity and the ability to hook these organisms up to electrode surfaces. We have the ability to change the potential of that electrode surface and alter that community structure. The whole community that's using that electrode surface either as an electron donor or as an electron acceptor by modulating or changing that potential, you can observe a response at the community level.
With a community of bacteria connected to an electrode, you can send pulses of electrical potential throughout the entire network. He's like a neurologist stimulating a patient's brain with implanted electrodes.
You can observe a response at the community level. That will be evidence, strong evidence, that there is neurological or neurobiological activity in the microbial community, and we will be talking to them.
The ocean could have a brain made up of bacterial and animal life that exists all through the upper layers of ocean sediment. This brain could be capable of thoughts very different from our own. There are 100 trillion cells in the ocean sediment, far more than the number of neurons we have, and the ocean's electrical network provides over 1,000 times faster than our neural network. Eurus suspects that this brain network is spread across 140 million square miles of ocean floor. If so, its thoughts would play out over hundreds, if not thousands, of years.
So what could the ocean be doing? The ocean's been around a long time. Those organisms that are at the bottom of the ocean, possibly integrated into these neural networks, they've been around for billions of years. So it's probably very contemplative thought.
If the ocean ecosystem collectively forms a living, thinking being, it could see us as a threat to its survival. It may decide to immunize itself against us. We could be wiped out. But we are also intelligent creatures. Couldn't we learn how to read the ocean's mood?
Discovery Science is a new channel we've got. Yes, that's right. You can now find us on YouTube and Facebook, where you can catch the hints of our brand new shows, exclusive interviews, and new discoveries that you go through. So if you don't want to miss out, subscribe and like this on your Discovery Science.
From the mystery of street magic to electrifying stage illusions, discover the secrets. A show dare to ask the question, is it science? Or is it magic? It's got to be seen to be believed.